Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is Tsiren speaking and today's speed build I'm gonna be building a Spanish inspired villa. After the Sims 3 museum I needed a change where I could use a lot of colors and I imagine that Spanish homes and families are very cheerful, colorful, warming and welcoming, which was a huge change after my museum. And of course this build can be downloaded from the Sims 4 gallery. And I have posted a link in the description below. You can also search my origin ID, which is Tsiren Sims, and check out my other build as well. If you like my builds and video, please follow and subscribe to my channel on Twitter, YouTube and Twitch for more uploads. And as always, if you don't have time to watch the entire speed build, I have a video tour in the end for you to enjoy. I am currently building in Oasis, which I think is a very suitable place for a home like this. I am building on a 40 by 30 lot and the villa itself isn't that huge in my opinion, but there are just about enough rooms for the family. It's not a very complex or an advanced building either, but this house is more about the interior and furnishing where I can explore with different styles and colors and not worry about if this or that fits or work together. This is a home like for normal regular people, not celebrities or super rich people. Of course they can live here as well, but I assume and imagine that they would want something more fancy and maybe something more modern. So more or less regular people like me, only that I live in a 60 square meters apartment and of course I do not have a pool. So I guess this is a bit above my pay grade after all. I just have to tell you, when I was a kid, I was watching these TV shows of houses where people showing off their homes. Obviously, I have always been interested in houses and interior, even though I'm not good at it. But in these shows, I remember I saw this Spanish villa once that had this amazing outdoor area with a huge sofa area, dining table, fireplace. It was much bigger than what I am making here, but it was under this roof and had a lot of arches along the walls that were leading out to the garden. So I wanted to have something similar, even though mine is a lot smaller than the house I saw on the TV. It would still be a pretty nice outside area. If I ever gonna have a house where there will be warm all year around, I will have something similar as well. I really fell in love with this and this was ages ago, I mean decades ago in plural, and I still remember, not as if it was yesterday, but well enough to still want it. So I was really having fun making this and I wanted this to have like a barbecue area as like a second kitchen, a dining table and a very cozy TV section or something. So the family who lives here have Spanish ancestors of course. And there are two adults there, mom and dad, and there are four children, two kids where there are one boy and a girl, a teenage daughter and a young adult son. The last family member that lives here is of course the mother-in-law. In certain movies we always see these families that take care of the mothers and let them stay in their house and stuff like that. We don't do that normally in Norway, we put them in homes so other people can take care of them, to be honest. So I imagine that this family they like to take care of their own. I don't know if that's true or if that's just in movies, but it doesn't really matter. I thought it would be a real nice gesture and a nice thing to do. I'm not quite sure what these people are gonna do for a living. I imagine that they may own a restaurant or a small diner. Could be something family, traditional-like maybe, I don't know. Or I am gonna use a lot of flowers here in this build, so maybe they are like botanist? Is that a word? Botanist? I'm not sure. You know, they are like growing and selling their own flowers and plants, if you know what I mean. Gardener, is that a word I'm looking for? I don't know. I'm sorry, my vocabulary is all off today. Anyway, I think that would be a very nice working with flowers, grow them and sell them in maybe a small niche store or maybe even in a really huge plantation or something. I can never do that. My plants dies as soon as they enter my doorstep, and that's true. I actually wanted to work with flowers, be like this flower decorator when I was younger, but I'm glad I didn't do that because I would probably get fired for killing all the plants. But I imagine this family, well, they actually can do both. They can own a diner and they can own this flower shop. That would be nice. So, yeah, that's a bit of the background and the story for this build and the family who lives here. Oh, I'm not sure if I've told you, but I have gotten a job myself. It's not a very fancy job, but it is a job. Well, I work in this electronic store where I at the moment are selling dishwashers, washing machines, freezers and stuff like that. It's kitchen supplies. But my main job will soon be selling kitchen. Like, I'm gonna draw a kitchen for people that want to redecorate their homes. So literally only in a less professional program I'm gonna be a kitchen builder like The Sims. I don't know if you can call Sims a professional program, but definitely more professional than what I have seen, what I'm gonna use. I am still waiting for someone to learn me how it's done though. I've been waiting for weeks and it really sucks knowing that I'm gonna start with this part in less than 2 weeks and still no one had given me the program to work with yet, so it's a bit sad times, I guess. But I think it will be really fun. It's a poorly paid job compared to me being a real estate agent, but I love the environment. The people there are really nice and welcoming. I am used to work in a really small environment with two people, maybe up to four people max, but here there's a lot of people. A lot. Seriously. It's really awesome. I have always someone to talk to, we laugh and have fun while we're selling stuff, and me, I want to learn anything, and one of the older ones and I work together and there is someone there, I ask him if he can tell me something about certain products or certain things. So he sort of tells me, I take notes and I try to use that next time I get a customer for that product. And in that way, we are walking around in our part of the shop and just talk. I want to be that good as well. But lately, I have had this high school student with me, learning me how to do things. The other guy has been there for 27 years, so he knows a lot about the stuff we're selling. But he had a vacation since it's Easter, and I have been working, as I said, with this high school student. It's really fun too, but it's not as educational or as productive though. And for some reason, which is fairly annoying, that we are selling tons of stuff that have negative incomes, which basically means we are losing a lot of money when we are selling that kind of product, which is pretty much everything. Like, they're having all these items that if we sell it might cost us 4,000 in minus. Honestly, who does that? And I did actually sell a freaking oven that we lost 5 grand in. I was mortified. I didn't know that until it was too late. So now I am literally checking everything that I sell before I sell it. And if we lose money, I recommend something else. Like, we don't have that, or you can only get the one that is on display, which people really want. I don't know how we're supposed to keep this store running, but then again, this is not for me to worry about, is it? Anyway, this house is my first build with the Laundry Day stuff pack. I instantly fell in love with this pack and pretty much everything in it. So recently I have two new packs which I am using a lot in this build, both Jungle Adventurer and Laundry Day. Of course, I use a lot of other packs too, but in this home they were a perfectly good match. I love getting new packs, but it's fairly expensive, but I love it. I know that a lot of people use CC, but I don't do that. But I think it's a great way to get items if you don't want or can't spend money on these packs. I know some will see it as cheating, but I see it as a good alternative for not spending money. And to be honest, a lot of the items are way better as well. I've seen pictures, it's amazing what people can do. So the upper floor is a little different than the first floor. You can kind of say that this has been redecorated a little. It's a little intentionally because the oldest son have his room here. And it looks a little like that he have his own section of the house for himself. Kind of like his own private living room, bathroom and balcony. He don't really have that, but I wanted to give him some space. So it's rarely that someone comes up in this part of the house unless they want to use the biggest bathroom. His bedroom is fairly large as well. At first I thought this would be a nice room for the teenage daughter, but I changed my mind because as I started to work, I came to think about how I would want it if I had to be living with six other people. So I thought that the oldest had a right to live a little separately, since he is in his 20s or maybe even more. Also, I just have to say, some of the rooms looks a little different in the video though than what I'm making here. I made some changes because I wasn't quite happy with some of the rooms, but there is not any major changes. So there will be three living rooms here. I thought this could be like a regular living room with a sofa area and stuff like that. And as you see, there is a lot of balconies around this house, which I'm gonna make sure to fill up with a lot of furniture and flowers. Even though this floor might look a little more modern and different, I am still using a lot of furniture and clutters that you also see downstairs. I still want this floor to look like it's a part of the rest of the house, because obviously it is. The next living room will at the end turn out to be a small gaming room where I have placed this soccer game table, and I will also have this llama game table. This could be the family gathering room for Friday night's fun, and the third living room will more or less turn out to be a small library. The grandmother's room is in this part of the house, so it will almost be like she have her own part as well. So when it is too much noise and drama downstairs, she can retreat to her own peaceful place. And I'm also giving her or maybe the father his own small office to work in, so he can distance himself from the rest of the family undisturbed when he's doing important paperwork. Maybe it's the mother's office, I don't know. It's up for you guys to decide. I was really trying to make the grandmother's bedroom look like a grandmother's bedroom. I have to say, I had so much fun while making this room. I was giggling and laughing of my own, and I think I succeeded quite well actually. You'll all see what I mean a little later, but I think I have to cut off here. I am off to work in less than an hour, so I have to get ready. Thank you so much for watching, it's always a pleasure, and I also have to say thanks to all that have followed me on Twitter and subscribed to my channels. I really, really appreciate it. And remember, if you like my videos and builds, please follow and subscribe to my channel on Twitter, YouTube and Twitch for more uploads. Search my origin idea, which is Tsiren Sims, and check out my other builds as well. You can also leave me a comment below and let me know what you liked and what you didn't like so I can improve my future builds and video. So until next time, take care everyone. Bye bye.